strange doings, sir. I killed a hound in the yard, and it got straight back up and went for me. I had to crush its skull to be sure.
grow sick of this assassin. The other sisters speak of him with a tiny shudder of awe in their voices. Like stupid school. The hounds were wolves, or the statues, and then send on him like a murder of crows, and will pick his bones up.
Should we go down?
Thank you. before the district was run down.
Emily. Ramsay or one of the others will move in. The city needs whale oil.
Let them tear each other apart. We'll feast on the spoils. Really, sister. You have to have your mind.
Get up now! Come out, dear. It's no use.
Of course.
They're more than statues. She's put her will in them, and in the void, their power is much greater. Do not fret, sweet Tilda. Lady Delilah needs you to be strong and steadfast. This is no time to wilt like a summer daisy.
I won't. Forgive me, sister. You're right.
Wake up! I can't be sleeping now.
I gave you.
The void. Time to see what you've really got, Delilah.
I must say.
paint flows. Blood flows. Life goes. Out with the old. In with the new. You've lived in these bones long enough.
I'll find you! I will not be beaten! Curse you all! I will not!
I scouted, sir. Strange doings, sir. I killed a hound in the yard. And it got straight back up and went for me. I had to crush its skull to be sure.
grow sick of this assassin. The other sisters speak of him. The shudder of all.
Don't worry, love. The hounds will warn us. Or the statues. And then we'll decide.
District was run down. Thank you.
I'm glad I found you.
Show yourself, little.
was not supposed to be here. Nothing mattered. Another spirit. I heard something.
Find a void!
Delilah's side during the final moments of the ritual. She's alone. What if something goes wrong? Who will help her? Doesn't it worry you?
You underestimate our great lady's resourcefulness. She is not alone. Not entirely.
The statues. Of course.
They're more than statues. She's put her will in them. And in the void, their power is much greater. Do not fret, sweet Tilda. Lady Delilah needs you to be strong and steadfast. This is no time to wilt like a summer daisy.
I won't. Forgive me, sister. You're right.
I gave.
see what you've...
Paint flows, blood flows, life goes, out with the old, in with the new. You've lived in these bones long enough.
I'll find you!
Flows. Blood flows.
No! You can't do this!
Paint flows. Blood flows. Life go. No one will ever know it. I have one more surprise for you. I asked for my life. When I killed your empress and took her daughter, something broke inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How in these last days you passed through Coldridge Prison like a shadow, dared the tangles of Dunwall's underworld, and walked out unscathed, outwitted one of the greatest witches in a generation, all with consummate care and skill. How you saved Emily Caldwin, daughter of the Empress, first of her name, and no one will ever know. But how does it end for Dowd, the hired killer, the murderer, the savior of the Empire? It's up to Corvo now.
my life.
Paint flows. Blood flows. Life.
I scouted, sir.
Dowd, have you slain all my sisters? Well, it doesn't matter. I can carry on. I must say, I'm surprised. You see? Have you seen?
writing? Where is it?
Painted in the same style as Emily's portrait.
Emily Caldwin, daughter of Jessamine Caldwin, heir to the Empire of the Isles. I call out to you from the void. I call you with ochre from Morley, carmine beetle shells, zirconin lazurite, viridian bile. The tones of were flesh I tempered with Pandician chalk. The same loom that spun the fabric of your dresses made this canvas. I made my brushes from the hairs of your own scalp. Emily, you cannot ignore me. My power is too deep, my reach too long. Brush touches canvas. Brush touches void. And now I see you, Emily Caldwin. I breathe your breath. I can feel what you do. Bright mornings in the pub. I feel the cold night air of the ruin where you sleep. And the stink of the river. In which strikes the eye. I touches the mind. Mind touches the world. Your breath, the corvo attendant, and your lost mother. For your caretaker, Callista. I feel your fear in the night. Your hunger to learn. To become someone important. My hunger too. My fear. You are becoming mine. We are nearly finished. Close your eyes, Emily. Forever. Feel the void open beneath you. Make room for me. Give in to me, Emily. Give in to me now! Paint flows.
Blood flows. Life goes. Out with the old, in with the new. You've lived in these bones long enough, sweet young boy. It is complete. I am. What? What's happening? This is all wrong! What am I becoming? Outsider blood! Is this some trick? Goad!
No one will ever know exactly what it took. No one will save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider, who watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts. I have one more surprise for you. I asked for my life. When I killed your empress and took her daughter, something broke inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How in these last days you passed through Coldridge Prison like a shadow, dared the tangles of Dunwall's underworld, and walked out unscathed, outwitted one of the greatest witches in a generation, all with consummate care and skill. How you saved Emily Caldwin, daughter of the Empress, first of her name, and no one will ever know. But how does it end for Dowd, the hired killer, the murderer, the savior of the Empire? It's up to Corvo now.